who joins us here today from the Fairfax County Public Schools Secondary Transition Employment Program, the STEP program. And Fidel came to the States when he was 4 years old from Morocco, looking for a better quality of life and a way to communicate. He is looking forward to sharing his story about assistive technology devices in his work environment. And the screen behind us is actually mirroring Fidel's communication device, so you're able to see it will be like a demonstration of the device that he uses. So we're very much looking forward to hearing from you, Fidel, and please welcome Fidel Rock.
Hello, my name is Fidel Rock. I am 20 years old, and I attend the STEP program at Fairfax County Public Schools. I took off from work today to tell you how my assistive technology devices help me participate at work. And what my life and job would be like without it. For one thing, I wouldn't be communicating with you all right now. Some people may look at me and think that just because I cannot feed myself or speak using my mouth, that I cannot work like you. This is not true. With my devices, I can go between the keyboard for speaking, the computer, and even make phone calls and text my friends and supervisor. While you may type with your hands, I type with my eyes. I access controls on my screen and use the same Microsoft tools like when writing my resume and filling out forms. But instead of signing with a pen, I use Adobe Fill and Sign to add my signature. Let me tell you about the device you see in front of me. I use a PRC Accent 1400 with new voice software. I use a PRC. Everything on my device is controlled by iGaze technology. I no longer have to wait for someone to ask me questions and guess what I have to say. My device gives me a way to ask my own questions to co-workers and friends and chat about anything I choose. I even have my cell phone hooked up so I can text, call, and access transit sites to learn ways to get around. I love listening to music and checking out who won the last soccer game. My current job is at the Mount Vernon Healthcare Center. I lead leisure activities for residents by providing instructions for the activities. I encourage and talk to everyone. I sometimes tell the residents about the scores for the football games. Without my device, I would just sit there and do nothing. Instead, I would have to listen to others questioning me and use my gestures to play the yes and no game. The residents and myself would probably be bored, and my interactions would be shallow. I might also be ignored by others. Prior to working at the Mount Vernon Healthcare Center, I worked at the National Science Foundation. It was an exciting challenge for me because I had to learn how to use a new technology to complete my job. I had to adapt to using it to a PCI plus. The camera bar attaches to the monitor and then to the laptop using a USB. This system gave me full control of using all computer controls. This let me get through a lot of data entry in the NSF database. use my assistive technology, my co-worker worked from the suite right next to me. Same job, different ways to access. If I did not have my devices, I would not have been able to do my work and share my ideas with others. I might also then work from home and have no interactions with others. Instead, my assistive technology lets me work on site. For people with no special needs, I want you to imagine a simple gesture of scratching your nose with your finger. It is indeed very simple and you can do it without thinking about it. Now, put yourself in a situation where you are not able to use your hands to reach your face. You cannot use your hands to point in each area. And add to that, you cannot talk and say you have an itchy nose. How will you communicate to others this request? The use of an eye gaze device is a lifesaver. It takes a few seconds to express a need that will be impossible to communicate otherwise. I may still be waiting for someone to ask me the right yes and no questions. Thank you for listening to how my assistive technology makes me part of the competitive employment workforce. My assistive technology has changed over the years. Who would have thought that I could carry my new iPlus and just plug it into any Windows 10 computer and have instant access to a computer and the internet? In class, we learned about having an elevator speech ready to go. Since I take elevators a lot, here is mine. My name is Fidel Rock, and I work with technology. My passion is cybersecurity. As you may see or hear, I use a communication device to speak. I may take an extra moment to answer. Please be patient while I am typing. I will never give up. My card is in my right pocket on my wheelchair. Please send me an email with your contact information. Thank you.
And before we get started on the panel discussion, since it's a smaller group today, I just want to take a moment because I see someone in the audience that we owe many thanks to. Michael Gamble McCormick is in the back of the room, and he works for Senator Casey, who, first of all, their office secured this room for us today and was also one of the sponsors on